move their mouth, and I just move their mouth and out of your way altogether. And I've had to do that. So what I'm saying to you is, no matter what your mountain is, wherever your level of faith is going to determine if you can move that mountain or not. That mountain, like I said, could be drugs and alcohol. It could be additions to various things in our life. It could be finding a better job. It could be a financial situation. It could be, you know, whatever the devil has put before you and you're struggling with it. That's a mountain in your life that's keeping you from seeing the other side. And the other side is where Jesus wants us to be. That's where he laid his life down so we can get to the other side of the mountain. You know, so I'm standing here before you today to tell you that your mountain is only as big as your faith. If your faith is small, you'll never move it. No matter how much you pray, no matter how much you cry, no matter how much you seek counseling, no matter what you do, because if you are listening to someone tell you what you need to do, but if it's not in your heart and in your spirit to believe it, then it's not going to happen. You can wish all you want. You can plan. You can do everything you want to do. But that thing, that mountain is going to be there if your faith is not where it's supposed to be. Now I want you to know that I've been a faithful member here for, you know, since I've been here. I enjoy Northside, and I enjoy my sisters and brothers here. It's because everything that all ties in together. The way I see you operate in faith, when I was a babe in mine, that would encourage me to grow in my faith, because I watched your faith walk. And that was important to me. I needed to see how it worked and how to keep it and not just have it for a moment or for a time when I need it, then lay it down. It's something that you have to apply to your life every minute of your life, not just when you need it. Apply your faith when it's not even necessary. You know, just it's always there for you to use. And I can think, and I just want to take a moment before I close here. First of all, I want to thank Pastors James and Merlin Hill. Because sometimes in your faith walk, you need some assistance to help you move mountains. God, give us that. You know, and I tell you, these two people here, you know, I call them the Hill and Hill Spiritual Law Firm. Because I needed some help in an area that I was totally unfamiliar with. And things wasn't moving in my behalf. Matter of fact, I was losing ground. But I asked them to help me out, and they came to my aid. See, God is always seeing ahead of us. Because of Sister Hill's background, you know, in her previous job, it played right into my hands. So she used what she had, and Pastor Hill backing her up. We were able to move what I was trying to do for months. We did in a week. I mean, things just turned around in a matter of days. The thing that I was, the mountain I was trying to move, and I was just punching at it, hitting at it, kicking at it, screaming at it. just doing everything in my might that I could do. Of course, my faith kept me in the fight, kept me in the game, because I wasn't giving up. Because I knew that things was going to move eventually. But sometimes things have to be carried along. And if it wasn't for them, it's just a blessing that God put them on my path, as it done so many of you on my path, so I can see faith working. So quickly, I want to thank Sister Mary Ann. She's my financial advisor, and I can tell you, without her things wouldn't be happening for me in my life right now, the way they are. She kept me stable. She kept me sound. Helped me with my finances, made sure I was dotting the I's, crossing the T's, checking up on me when she didn't hear from me, just making sure that I was following the letter. And for that, you know, I'm financially sound. And I thank God for her for being not just my financial advisor, but my very, very good friend. All of you, man, all of you, are the reason why I'm here today. Because Sister Kalila, she's my very good friend. This past year or so, we've been fellowshipping with each other. And it was necessary for us to do that because she's at a place in her life where she needed a friend. I'm at a place in my life where I needed a friend. And she's been a very good friend. She helps keep me grounded. If I could explain this right, she keeps me from running wild. You know, because when those urges, you know, I could talk to her, you know, she talks me down. She helped keep me in my place, keep reminding me who I am in Christ. And of course, and I do the same for her. So it's friends like her, the Sister Mary Ann, and my brothers, Rod, my sister Yasmin. It takes the village to raise a Christian. Amen. Amen.
All right, Brother Charlie got kind of deep, didn't he? All right, wasn't that good? All right, these brothers are doing excellent. We got a lot to look for this month. Every brother,